Hi guys, happy Friday. It's dark, like actually legit dark. So I have this cute little clip-on ring light. I have the light on in my car. So I'm trying to get you the best light that I can. I look crazy, but it's fine. At least you can see me and we can chat a little bit about my week. So I have some incredibly exciting news. So if you are on my Facebook group or follow me on Instagram, you know that earlier this week, I went to my very first jazzercise class. Now, what jazzercise is it's sort of a dance class that you incorporate some weights and some just weights using your natural body weight. It is so fun. A girl from my Weight Watchers meeting invited me. We went together on Tuesday, and then we went together last night, and I'll get back to last night. But oh my gosh, you guys. It was so fun, and what a crazy, intense, hardcore workout. They gave me a free pass so that I could check it out, see if I like it, and I am telling you right now, I'm joining. I don't care what the cost is, I'm joining. I loved it. The first day that I did the class on Tuesday, it was a dance mix, so I was tired. My legs felt tired the next day. But let me just tell you, yesterday we went to an interval dance mix and I thought, I'm good. As soon as I started, I could already feel my legs were sore. And then today, they are so sore. So incredibly sore. Just, it was hard to get out of bed. My arms are sore. My legs are sore. Everything is sore, but that's a good thing. Except when you step on the scale. And I even made a comment to my friend in the class yesterday. I was like, man, I really hope that this doesn't affect my weighing on the scale because I'm sore already from the other workout. And then yesterday was so incredibly intense. So I'm hoping it doesn't affect my weigh-in, but to be completely 100% honest with you, I don't care because it was so much fun and I feel my body tightening up already, which is crazy. The hour flies by. It is an hour of intense workout, 45 minutes of cardio, and then they wrap it up at the end with some weights incorporated with some cardio. And it is a solid nonstop hour. So let me know down in the comments, do you guys go to Jazzercise? Is there one in your area? Highly recommend. I am not a gym person. I'm bored out of my mind at the gym. I drag myself there when I go. I don't have to drag myself here. So far, I am absolutely loving it. Our goal is again to go tomorrow morning to the 8 o'clock a.m. class before I go to my open houses tomorrow. So I'm loving it. I'm thrilled, excited, grateful that I found an exercise that I actually like because winter is here and it is cold and dark and soon to be snowy. So walking outside is not an option. So huge, huge win this last week. You guys, I'm incredibly excited that I have found an exercise that I actually enjoy. In fact, I kept thinking I'm going to Vegas on Friday. Friday is the day I fly to Vegas because we have my Weight Watchers Jen's WW Tribe meetup in Vegas on Saturday. So all that information is on my Facebook group. So if you're not part of my group, it's right there, guys. Go head over. We're just shy of 9,000 amazing, positive, spectacular members. So we're having a meetup and I thought, oh my gosh, I'm gonna miss my class. Isn't that crazy that I actually feel that way? So luckily in Vegas, I'll get a lot of walking. My girlfriend and I will probably do some other sort of exercise. My best friend is flying there to meet me as well. So super excited. So my week was great in exercise and in even better news, I had a great eating week. You guys, I was 100% on track all week from I had my cheat day or my cheat day on Saturday, like I always do. But then moving from then on track, did really well with my food, was able to give myself a star in my planner every single day. So incredibly exciting. So my food was on point. I found a new exercise. It really couldn't have been a better week. So let's see what happens when I step on the scale. I'll be back shortly to share with you not only my weigh-in results, cross your fingers that hardcore workout didn't too negatively affect me, and of course, this week's topic. Well, hello friends. I am out of my WW workshop. It is light out, but it is dreary. So I apologize for the not so good lighting. I literally have the light on in my car, even though it is 8 a.m. because it is just dreary outside today. I'm hoping the sun peeks out a little bit later, but 'Tis the season, right? So let's talk first about our workshop topic. Let me just tell you once again, WW, you did it once again. This topic was perfect. So today's topic was about hitting rewind to move forward. So how many times in your journey have you done something where you're like, oh, I wish I wouldn't have done that. I wish I could just hit the rewind button and start all over. How many times? I do it probably once a week, to be completely honest with you. I've been really refocusing. So this last week, I honestly could say that I didn't want to hit the rewind button at all. But for the majority of the weeks, I always want to hit that rewind button at least once. I want to do over, a start over. I want to start clean with a fresh, clean slate. So how many times do we do that in our journey? We need to figure out how we can rewind our journey to move forward in our journey. So I have three fabulous tips to share with you. So the first step is to imagine a video recording. You've recorded that day in your life. Now take yourself back 24 to 48 hours and watch that videotape. See what steps you took that led to your decision. What were you thinking in your mind? What were the circumstances surrounding what happened? So let's really focus on a specific example. So let's say that you went through the McDonald's drive-thru for lunch. So let's rewind, say 24 hours. What caused you to have to go through the McDonald's drive-thru? Did you not plan your meals? Did you not bring snacks? Did you not eat breakfast before you ran out the door of the house and you were so hungry that anything sounded good, you stopped at the first available place? What happened that led you to going through the McDonald's drive-thru? And then we want to watch, how did we feel after we ate the McDonald's food? Were we happy? Were we satisfied? Were we beating ourselves up? What happened? So take a moment, think back 24 to 48 hours, rewind that videotape and watch yourself in your mind go through the motions of what led you to feel, darn it, I shouldn't have done that. Number two, pinpoint what you would change. So find the moment where you pulled into the McDonald's drive-thru. What would you do at this point? Would you stop and re-record? What would you do leading up to what caused you to go into the McDonald's drive-thru? So in the scenario that I have here, what I would have done is planned ahead. I would have brought my own food. I would have at very least brought a snack so that I wasn't so hungry that I had to go through the McDonald's drive-thru and I could have waited until I got home or even made a better choice for my lunch. So pinpoint the area where you would literally hit pause and want to re-record. And that really helps you analyze and focus on what led up to your ultimate decision. For example, another one, let's say you're at a work party and there's cupcakes. What would you have done? Pause yourself at the table with the cupcakes. What would you have done leading up to that to not eat the cupcake? Maybe the night before, maybe you need to rewind all the way to the night before so that you could have brought appropriate snacks so that you weren't hungry and craving the cupcakes. You most likely knew the work party was going to happen. So if you could go re-record, you would have brought your own something to the work party so that you weren't tempted by the cupcakes. So it's just important to pause and figure out the areas where you would want to re-record and redo and restart over. And number three, replay that tape with the edit that you made. Replay your new recording where you stopped, paused, and re-recorded. What changes would you have made? So let's first talk about the McDonald's situation. So a change that you could have made, you may have packed your own lunch. Even if you had to stop at the gas station like I do all the time and warm it up in their microwave, maybe you would have packed some snacks so that it would have at least tided you over until you could get to a better choice for lunch, whether that's at home or just making a better choice. You weren't so hungry that you took whatever you could get. And let's revisit the cupcakes at the work party situation. What would you have done different? Where would you have paused, re-recorded a better decision? Maybe you would have packed a little bag of grapes and maybe a sweet treat, maybe a Built Bar, maybe a little package, a pre-portioned package of gummies or chocolates or something that would still satisfy your sweet craving without having you reaching for the cupcakes at the work party. So that's the whole philosophy as the rewind in order to start over. We have to go back and revisit the decisions that we made that maybe weren't the best decisions before we can move forward and know what better decisions to make. So such a great topic, you guys, a great topic, because I can guarantee there isn't a single person on any type of weight loss journey that doesn't wish at some point that they could hit pause, rewind, and start over. All right, so now that we've talked about the fantastic topic at the workshop, let's talk a little bit about my weigh-in. So as I mentioned, I had a great week with food. I am so proud of myself. I would say, to be completely honest with you, this is one of the best weeks food-related that I had. I tracked everything. I stayed well within my points. I earned a blue dot every day. I was able to put a little star on my planner every day, which is ridiculous, but so fun for me. Helps me stay on track, helps me stay motivated. I started my new exercise routine, going to Jazzercise. I'm loving it. I'm actually going again tomorrow morning. Cannot wait. So I feel like since my journey started, I feel that sense of re-motivation, re-energized, re-excited about my journey. I think not only the food-related WW part, but also just my goal to become a healthier version of myself by incorporating some regular exercise. I'm feeling really good, you guys. Again, the best I felt in a long time. So for me, I don't even care what the scale says because I feel so good about everything that I'm doing. And I want to remind you guys that the scale isn't everything. The scale does not define who you are, does not make people love you, does not make you a beautiful person inside and out. The scale is simply a number, a measure of progress. It doesn't define who you are. What defines who you are is your character and what you're doing to better yourself, your life, your health. That defines who you are and the people that love you and the reasons that they love you. So just remember that the scale isn't the defining moment of your life. It's all the other things, your day to day, that are the defining moments of your life. I lost my light for a second. So now, after that, I stepped on the scale and I'm excited to announce that even though I am sore and I am certain my muscles are retaining a little bit of fluid because they're sore, I lost 1.6 pounds. I will take it. I'm excited. I'm on the right track. I'm seeing results. And the bad news is, so that's the good news. That's the good news. So the bad news is, as I mentioned before, I go to Vegas on Friday, so I won't be at my workshop Friday morning because my flight leaves really early because I actually get into Vegas at about 9:30 in the morning. So my goal is to go to the Wednesday morning workshop. You will see this video uploaded on Friday, as always, as weigh-in Friday, but it will be my results as of Wednesday. So that could be good, that could be bad. Because I am going to use my weeklies tomorrow, Saturday, and that only gives me a few days in between today's weigh-in and Wednesday to weigh in again, but it's okay. I want to get weighed in. I want to be able to talk about the topic with you guys and share my results, but just keep in mind that it's a shorter period of time between one weigh-in and another. But I'm going to be going to Jazzercise Saturday and Monday, and I might even go Tuesday or maybe Wednesday after my workshop. I am just loving this, you guys. I am loving life right now. Despite the weather, despite the cold, I'm feeling really good. Feeling really good. So I want to hear, how was your guys' week? What were your struggles? Did you gain? Did you lose? How do you feel the week went overall for you? My light turned off again. Sorry, guys. My car is kind of fancy in a sense that it knows that the light's been on and turns it off. So I apologize, you can still see me, so we'll take it. But comment down below, let me know how your week was. What are your goals for the upcoming week? And what do you think of this rewind to move forward idea? I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So you guys, thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to read your comments down below. Definitely hop over to my Facebook group right there if you're not already a member so that you can be part of the meetup. Even if you can't be there, I'm going to vlog the entire thing. You're going to see all the details. I'll share the journey with you. I'll pop onto Facebook throughout. Can't wait to share everything with you. And if you're new, make sure you hit that little subscribe button and that bell. That way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please thumbs up this one. And again, leave your comments down below. Let me know how your week was. Thank you guys for being by my side, staying by my side, being a positive, supportive force in my life. It truly means the world to me. And I'll see you guys all in the next video. Oh, stay tuned. I'm going to have the recipe on the back of the weekly. It sounds amazing. And I'll see you guys later.